Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I have for you a nail tutorial. Last video I did regarding my nails, you guys reacted so well to it. I have never had a video do so well. So I wanted to do a second part to it, an in-depth nail tutorial. My nails are this very pretty berry color. I think it is so fall. I think it is so perfect for this little season we're in right now. And so if you want to see how I achieved these nails, please keep watching. We are on the way to 500 subscribers. I am so, so excited about that. And thank you so much if you've already subscribed. If you are new here, welcome. And I hope you can join my little community. So let's jump right into this nail tutorial. The first thing that I always, always do before I do anything makeup, nails, is wash your hands. The next thing I do is I then go in with some cuticle oil on my freshly washed hands. This cuticle nail oil is going to prep those cuticles so you can have that salon looking manicure after you're done. The second step that I always do is push back my cuticles. You can use a metal cuticle pusher or a wooden cuticle pusher. I recommend using a bamboo or a wooden cuticle pusher instead of a metal one, just because it is so much better for your nails. As you can see, the metal one is super harsh. You have to be very, very gentle, and you have to make sure that you're not going to cut up your nails or damage them in any kind of way. After I push back my cuticles, I go in with a cuticle cutter. I use two different kinds. I'll show you here where I use one to kind of just go through and trim up all of my dead skin around my nail beds, and also go through and trim up all of that dead cuticle that I just pushed back. And then if anything is like a little bit too much to go in with that cuticle cutter, that the brown one, I go in with the metal one and just kind of chop it off really easily. And that to me is what really makes a difference between doing your nails at home and the salon manicure. And so I never, never miss that step. It is so easy and it makes the world of difference. After I've gotten done trimming all of the dead skin around my nails and clearing up my cuticles, the next thing that I do is I go in and shape my nail. I love the coffin nail, and I think it is very time consuming to achieve, and also it's kind of difficult in my opinion. So you really need to search YouTube tutorials. I am not an expert on shaping your nails, so I cannot give you a lot of advice on that. There's so many different nail types out there, and it's all up to you, whatever you want to do. And so that's my next step. I go in and shape my nail, kind of make everything even. And if you're going for that natural look, it's kind of like a square round, which your natural nail grows in, I would just recommend you filing them and cleaning them up and making them look even and like all of them are the same. I think that that's another key to making your nails look like you got them done at the salon, is when they're all even and when they're all the same style and length. The next step I do is I prep my nail for the polish. And so what I do is I take that rough nail file and I go over my nails just to kind of create a rough base for the base coat to stick on. This is going to ensure that your nail polish and your manicure lasts a lot longer than it would if you didn't do the step, because imagine just like you're painting a wooden table. You go over and you sand it down first before you paint it. If not, the paint is not going to stick as well or as long. So that's what you need to do. Or if you don't want to, if you want your manicure to last 3 days and you want to change it every 3 days, you can skip over this step. Mind you, this does jeopardize the integrity of your nail. Let me just go ahead and tell you that. This is why when you leave the nail salon, your nails are so thin underneath your acrylic that you just put on, because they filed that baby down. And so if you don't want that to happen to your nail, you can just go ahead and skip over this part. It is not critical to the overall look. I just think that it makes my nails last longer, and it makes the nail polish grip onto it a lot easier than if I didn't do this step. And so last things last for all the nail prep before I move on to the polishes is I go in with this scrubber and I go and exfoliate my nail beds. We just did a lot of work on them. We have oils on them. And we also have a lot of debris from the filing. And so I go and wash my hands and I really make sure to scrub my nails with this little nail scrubber that I'm showing you here. and this just ensures a clean base. Now after you've done this, make sure you dry your hands well and make sure there's no soap, no oil, and no excess moisture on your nails. Make sure they are completely dry. This is a crucial step. And then we can start with the base coat. So as you see here, I am applying the base coat, and this is the coat that is necessary if you're going to be doing gel nails at home or even in the salon. You have to apply the base coat, if not, the polish is not gonna stick on. And like I said, there are options that easy off base coats that if you don't like the fact that gel nails are so hard to take off, I know that they sell easy off base coats, and I'm just using the one that came with my nail kit that I bought from Amazon. And so I let the base coat cure anywhere from 60 to 120 seconds. The crucial step is to make sure you're not getting this nail polish or the base coat or the top coat on your fingers. It will wipe off, so make sure you have a Q-tip, make sure you have a rag or something to go through and clean up around your fingernail, because you do not want to cure that nail polish on your skin. Not only will it burn, it's gonna be hard to take off and it's gonna look sloppy, and that's another way to make your nails look like you did them at home. Moving on to the actual nail polish. I started off with a white layer. So in my last video that I did, I was talking about how a lot of the polishes are transparent. They're very opaque. And so a lot of you guys underneath that video said try a white nail polish underneath the color, and I have to say I think it came out so much better, because if I would have just placed that color on my actual nail, I would just would have had the same problem, even though this is a deeper berry color. Next, I go in and I use the actual color of my choice. This time was a pink berry color, which I think is perfect for bringing in September. And so I go in and I put three layers of this on, again making sure that I'm not getting it on my skin, because it does burn and it's so hard to take off of your skin. Now overall, I did a total of 4 coats of color. I did the white coat and 3 of the pink color, and I cured this at 30 seconds each. This is where it starts getting time consuming if you cure it for more than 30 seconds each, because you have to put it on, cure it, put it on, cure it. And obviously we're not at a salon where one hand can cure while she's working on the other hand. We're doing it all ourselves, and so this manicure does take a little bit more time, but I think it's so much worth it. It saves you so much money. Just being able to have the freedom to change up your nails whenever you want. If I go to a salon, I don't really have that freedom to do that, because I mean, I have to pay every single time. I have to go pay to take it off. I have to pay for them to redo it. And I just think if you are balling on a budget, even if you're not balling on a budget and you just want freedom of your nails, for you to change up the color with your outfit, whatever the case may be, it is so much easier to just do it at home and take the little extra time and save that money. The last step is to go through with a top coat. Now you can do a matte top coat or a glossy top coat or even a glittery top coat. They make several different ones. I only have a glitter one, a matte one, and a clear one, a clear glossy one. And so go over it. I cure that at 60 to 120 seconds just to make sure everything is cured, make sure everything is sealed. And that is one thing that I love, is that they cure instantly and they're dry almost instantly. I mean, after you cure them, you're good to go. And so this is how my nails turned out. So I really hope you enjoyed this video as much as you enjoyed the first one. If you are wondering and curious what video I am referring to, I will have it linked down below in the description box, as well as this manicure set and the nail polishes that I'm using. And I really hope you found this video informative. If you have any questions, please leave them down below in the comments. I'm always answering questions down there. And if you enjoyed, please leave a comment down below. I would really appreciate it, and it really helps out my channel. As well as make sure you hit that like button and consider subscribing if you enjoyed this video. I would highly recommend checking out my other videos if you're a little bit unsure. But as always, I will see you next Wednesday. And until then, I hope you have a great week. Bye.